Thank you. knew that was coming.
Yeah.
she go? She goes, oh, I got it.
Oh. So are you breeding with him?
Nice.
Oh, the Brady Bunch. Yeah. Baby Duffy. Oh.
Not yet.
Maybe.
Yes, three.
Okay. We're going to do one.
Stop.
Stop. Stop. Stop. Stop. Stop. Stop. Stop. Stop. Stop. Stop. Stop. Stop. Stop. Stop. Stop. Stop. Stop. Stop. Stop. Stop. Stop. Stop. Stop. Stop. Stop. Stop. Stop. Stop. Stop. Stop. Stop. Stop. Stop. Stop. Stop. Stop. Stop. Stop. Stop. Stop. Stop. Stop. Stop. Stop. Stop. Stop. Stop. Stop. Stop. Stop. Stop. Stop. Stop. Stop. Stop. Stop. Stop. Stop. Stop. Stop. Stop. Stop. Stop. Stop. Stop. Stop. Stop. Stop. Stop. Stop. Stop. Stop. Stop. Stop. Stop. Stop. Stop. Stop. Stop. Stop. Stop. Stop. Stop. Stop. Stop. Stop. Stop. Stop. Stop. Stop. Stop. Stop.
So, congratulations. You see how her shape is? She's bigger than what your Rhode Island is, isn't she? That's what we're looking for.
Oh,
got this. So what breed do you think it is? Does your mom have an idea?
Nope.
Okay. Well.
I wonder if you
it's actually a standard old English. So we usually see Bannon, they're standard also. So they were considered a fighting reason for fighting. To show them once they become a year old, all the wallows, the ears, and the comb all have to be cut off. You do that when you're on less blood flowing. But he's got 3 pieces of what he's supposed to be. Once you bring that tail off just a little bit too quickly, right now when he's relaxing, that's kind of the angle he's supposed to have. You work the feathers up and they lay down. But he's a little bit sunburned too, and they don't like it. They tend to sunburn. So if he wasn't in the sun, those would begin to white out and become more silver. And the variety. Yeah. Do whatever he wants. So they're called silver ducklings. And because he's out, he keeps getting more natural yellow polish from the sun.
Depending on how loud they are. You're welcome to try it. When the breeze comes through, it's not bad.
Not wait till he's done.
But yeah, tonight.
You have help. Let's help him, whatever.
Vacation in the fall, and it was fun. So we're sticking the awards on them. I wish the stickers would reflect the ribbon. But the stickers reflect the ribbon.
Thank you. Thank you. design on the office thing.
Thank you. Hey, girls.
Hey.
Thank you.
can grab a neck. You grab a leg or a wing, sometimes you break them. You can't break the neck. So you grab them by the neck. You just control it. All right? About that. So this is your best one, okay? Nice size, nice length of the body, very nice neck and head. This one's pretty good. I'd like to see a little bit more, deeper chest on. Just a little more deep in your chest. That's still pretty good. Both of them are pretty good. Alright? Good job bringing them in. Now it took a while. We just don't want to be touched. Are you that one? I have to go. Oh, man. In between, but I like the carriage on him as an exhibition. His body like he's supposed to carry, and the female has that whip that she's going to pass that on and give that to his offspring. So that's a very nice pair. That'll be my top breeding pair. That's going to be my gold breeding pair. I'm also looking at the width of the head, the length, the width of the neck. And that, as you watch the drake walk around in here, both the drake and the hen both in that pen, they're more level to the ground. That's commercial line. It's got that angle pin. That's not exhibition line. This is exhibition platform. There's an exhibition. 1, 2, 3, and 4. Oh, sweet. She's supposed to have a sweet. She's got a sweet also. Those two are your pair. There, okay? Him. I'm moving on. You don't need that tail. Okay? So if you're going to breed, that hen, that rooster, really, really good.
We're going to breed in here. Okay? Right here. Yeah, look at what we're doing here. Come on.
Should be breeding pairs. Yeah. Should be one here.
Okay, but did you place the...
Okay.
cute. You're so cute. Look. What? You're cute but ugly. Yeah. Oh, my blood. It's cold.
Thank you.
Let's give these two a round of applause for coming out and doing this. So I love picking on elementary kids, especially those in third grade and those going into fifth grade. So we had some fun, didn't we? All right. So we talked a little bit about the breed and what was important about the breed, what was different. We talked about number of days it takes for an egg to hatch. And we took chicken and duck and see how much they knew. So we want some knowledge as well as how you handle the birds. So they did pretty good handling the birds. The Australorp, they're just a little bit less cooperative, but these are kind of smaller cages for a bigger bird. So both of them did real well. But my top showman is going to be the young man right here. Congratulations, and my runner-up. Okay.
I'm a junior.
Junior showmanship, please come to the table.
Now reach in.
Hard to get it out.
Thank you.
two in this class and ask them some questions about their bird, their individual birds. I also asked them some questions about the species and stuff like that, and they were able to answer my questions pretty good. I shared some things during the day, and this young man was able to repeat some of that right back to me, so I value that. He's been listening, and I threw a lot at him today, so he did a very good job today. And so he'll be your champion in this group. She'll be your reserve, and congratulations.
Showmanship, give me just a couple seconds to clean off the table and then you can put your birds in the cage. We're gonna get pictures at the end, so don't leave.
I'm gonna drive it back. I'll just drive it back. Thank you. I to get a white shirt in case I decide to wear it.
At this stage in their showing, I want to be able to tell me the breeds and the varieties that are associated with that breed. Something special about that breed. Those kinds of things. If you're going to bring me out a duck, as down here, bring me out a duck, tell me why a duck's important in Indiana. Indiana's number one producer of duck in the world. They harvest the meat, they harvest the feathers, or they make down, they grind them up, they harvest the feet and bills for egg drop soup. Ever had that? That's where that comes from. A lot of those are shipped to the Orient, so it's international money that comes into Indiana. All right. They also harvest the eyes. The eyes have the same sensitivity as a human eye. They're good for 8 days after harvest. So all eye makeup, ladies, your eye makeup was tested on duck eyes. Contact solutions, eye medication, Visine, all those kind of things are tested on duck eyes. Sporting black, guys. Super Bowl couldn't happen without ducks testing that. Sporting black, World Series, all traced back to Indiana ducks. Very important. Very, very important. Gucci purses. How many of you ladies like Gucci purses? Leather Gucci purses start at $1,000 each. The leather is tanned by duck brains. About the size of your thumb. All right. Indiana's number one producer of all those things because the ducks. Brings in money. Raising chickens. Number one producer of female chicks in the entire world in Indiana. Very important. Almost 1 billion female chicks are hatched and shipped all over the world from Indiana. We produce eggs, we produce meat, we produce turkey. We hatch more turkeys in Indiana than any other state. We hatch more broilers in Indiana. We're not the top in the production because we send them out. We sell them, bring money in. So if you combine all of poultry together, whether they believe it or not over there, poultry brings in more money in Indiana than swine, beef, and sheep combined. Brings in more money than the auto industry. All right, those are all important things. So if you bring me a at birds, tell me something about why it's important. Those are things, they're there. I asked all the kids in all the age groups, how many days does it take for a chicken egg to hatch? 21 days. Duck, 28 days unless it's a Muscovy. 32, 34 days with a Muscovy. Geese, turkeys, guineas, well, guineas are 21. Turkeys and geese are 28, just like the duck. We have pigeons in there, so it's fair game. Pigeons hatch in 19 days. We had quail eggs here today. Quail eggs hatch in that 16, 17 day range. So all that's important, all right? All the things that we add to it, and all the things that say a little bit about who we are, what we're about, and what's going on. So, do I just have my top winner in this group?
Yeah.
Okay, my top winner today is going to be this young lady right here, because she told me a lot more about the varieties, what varieties were available and stuff like that. Just that normal information about the breed, about what you're showing, and all that adds to. The rest of you have some very good skills handling the birds, just need to add more information. All right, and I'd like you to start at the top of the head and start walking down through. They have two wings, they have two legs, so show me both. You're judging that bird to me and tell me about what is important about that bird, about that species. So anyway, congratulations. Spot, and that's called a mangle. You know that even if you don't show it, last competition, all questions are fair game, right? And in the Masters, which that would be you, I can even ask you about the gestation on a pig. Okay, so gestation on a chicken egg is 21 days. That's how long it takes for it to hatch. Gestation, how long it takes for that baby to develop to be born. So on a pig, it's three months, 3 weeks, 3 days, 3 hours. And if you want to have a lot of fun, 3 minutes, 3 seconds. You get the judge to laugh. Get the judge to laugh. That's fun. All right? Screw that out. But sheep, cattle, all that. Okay. In Masters, I would expect you to start having some of those knowledge. If you were in a round robin showmanship, you'd have to answer this next question. All right? Again, how much do you know about Indiana? Indiana, poultry's important, but so are the pigs, so are the cattle, so are the sheep. And you guys have the opportunity to learn about that particular country. When I'm down State Fair and I have a mother go through and point at baby chicks being hatched and say, now when these grow up, they will produce the milk that we bring home from the grocery store. Oh, you all smile. You all know better than that? Unfortunately, a lot of people today don't know the difference. You guys should always know the difference. You know something about duck eyes that you didn't know before. You want to gross the boys out at school, especially in ag class or science class? Throw that information out. As a substitute teacher, I can gross the kids out quicker than anybody. But you know what? They've learned something. I get you a smile. You learned something. That's fun. We have lots of babies. Wow. Thank you very much, girls. You did a very good job. The boys are scared of you. All right.
Keep your chicken.
Let's give these two a round of applause for coming out and doing this. So I love picking on elementary kids, especially those in third grade and those going into fifth grade. So we had some fun, didn't we? All right. So we talked a little bit about the breed and what was important about the breed, what was different. We talked about number of days it takes for an egg to hatch. And we talk chicken and duck and see how much they knew. So we want some knowledge as well as how you handle the birds. So they did pretty good handling the birds. The Australorp, they're just a little bit less cooperative, but these are kind of smaller cages for a bigger bird. So both of them did real well. But my top showman is going to be the young man right here. Congratulations, and my runner-up. Okay.
I'm a junior.
Junior showmanship, please come to the table.
Now reach in.
I just got it.
The design. I used to mail these out.
I folded it and shoved it in.
Well, I was like, I could put it in my phone, but then I was like, I put it in.
Yes, he's going to die.
Okay, I went to in this class and asked them some questions about their bird, their individual birds. I also asked them some questions about the species and stuff like that, and they were able to answer my questions pretty good. I shared some things during the day, and this young man was able to repeat some of that right back to me, so I value that. He's been listening, and I threw a lot at him today, so he did a very good job today. And so he'll be your champion in this group. She'll be your reserve, and congratulations.
Showmanship, give me just a couple seconds to clean off the table and then you can put your birds in the cage. We're gonna get pictures at the end, so don't leave.
I'm gonna grab it and come back. I'll just grab it and come back.
gonna bring her back out.
Thank you.
work for the day?
No, I came in this morning and then I came
At this stage in their showing, I want to be able to tell me the breeds and the varieties that are associated with that breed, something special about that breed, those kinds of things. If you're going to bring me out a duck, as down here, bring me out a duck, tell me why a duck's important in Indiana. Indiana's number one producer of duck in the world. They harvest the meat, they harvest the feathers, for, they make down, they grind them up. They harvest the feet and bills for egg drop soup. Ever had that? That's where that comes from. A lot of those are shipped to the Orient, so it's international money that comes into Indiana. All right. They also harvest the eyes. The eyes have the same sensitivity as a human eye. They're good for 8 days after harvest. So all eye makeup, ladies, your eye makeup was tested on duck eyes. Contact solutions, eye medication, Visine, all those kind of things are tested on duck eyes. Sporting black, guys. Super Bowl couldn't happen without ducks testing that. Sporting black, World Series, all traced back Indiana ducks, very important, very, very important. Gucci purses. How many of you ladies like Gucci purses? Leather Gucci purses start at $1,000 each. The leather is tanned by duck brains. About the size of your thumb. All right, Indiana's number one producer of all those things because the ducks brings in money. Raising chickens, number one producer of female chicks in the entire world, in Indiana. Very important. Almost 1 billion female chicks are hatched and shipped all over the world from Indiana. We produce eggs, we produce meat, we produce turkey. We hatch more turkeys in Indiana than any other state. We hatch more broilers in Indiana. We're not the top in the production because we send them out. We sell them, bring money in. So if you combine all of poultry together, whether they believe it or not over there, poultry brings in more money in Indiana than swine, beef, and sheep combined. Brings in more money than the auto industry. All right, those are all important things. So if you bring me a bird, tell me something about why it's important. Those are things, they're there. I asked all the kids and all the age groups, how many days does it take for chicken egg to hatch? 21 days. Duck, 28 days unless it's a Muscovy. 32, 34 days with a Muscovy. Geese, turkeys, guineas. Well, guineas are 21. Turkeys and geese are 28, just like the duck. We have pigeons in there, so it's fair game. Pigeons hatch in 19 days. We had quail eggs here today. Quail eggs hatched in that 16, 17 day range. So all that's important, right? All the things that we add to it, and all the things that say a little bit about who we are, what we're about, and what's going on. So, do I just have my top winner in this group?
Yeah.
Okay, my top winner today is going to be this young lady right here, because she told me a lot more about the varieties, what varieties were available and stuff like that. Just that normal information about the breed, about what you're showing, and all that adds to. The rest of you have some very good skills handling the birds, just need to add more information. All right, and I'd like you to start at the top of the head and start walking down through. They have two wings, they have two legs, so show me both. But you're judging that bird to me and tell me about what is important about that bird, about that species. So anyway, congratulations. Three hours.
And if you want to have a lot of fun, 3 minutes, 3 seconds. You get the judge to laugh. Get the judge to laugh. That's fun. All right? Screw that app. But sheep, cattle, all that. Okay. In Masters, I would expect you to start having some of those knowledge. If you were in a round robin showmanship, you'd have to answer this next question. All right? Again, how much do you know about Indiana? Indiana, poultry is important, but so are the pigs, so are the cattle, so are the sheep. And you guys have the opportunity to learn about that because you live in the country. When I'm down State Fair and I have a mother go through and point at baby chicks being hatched and say, now when these grow up, they will produce the milk that we bring home from the grocery store. Oh, you all smile. You all know better than that. Unfortunately, a lot of people today don't know the difference. You guys should always know. You know something about duck eyes that you didn't know before. You want to gross the boys out at school, especially in ag class or science class? Throw that information out. As a substitute teacher, I can gross the kids out quicker than anybody. But you know what? They've learned something. I get you a smile. You learned something. That's fun. We have lots of people, don't we? Wow. Thank you very much, girls. You did a very good job. The boys are scared of you. All right.